these are going to be the warm-up problems. There's two of them. In the first one, we have some birds that are known for their maneuvering ability. So they're do a tight circular turn and time a centripetal acceleration that is 1.5 times g, the acceleration due to gravity. So this is 9.8 meters per second squared. So the centripetal acceleration is 14.7 meters per second. If the bird is flying at 25 meters per second, what is the radius of curvature? Radius of this circle? Oh, we know that the centripetal acceleration is a different color. Is the magnitude of velocity squared by the radius. This implies that the radius is velocity squared over centripetal acceleration. And this is 12.5 g. Okay. So then the radius is going to be 5 meters per second squared divided by 14.7 meters per second squared. So that's 625 meters squared second squared divided by 14.7 meters per second squared. Second squares go away, and each meter goes away. Again, our meters. So the radius is 42.5 meters. For the second one, says that to withstand G forces up to 10 G's caused by suddenly pulling out of a steep dive, fighter jet pilots train on a human centrifuge. Okay, so it's going to be also okay. If the length of the centrifuge arm is 12 meters, at what speed is the fighter moving when she experiences 10 G? And so here we're going to use the same equation of the centripetal acceleration. But we know the radius is going to be 12 meters. And we know the centripetal acceleration is going to be 10 times g. 10 times 9.8 meters per second squared. That will be 98. And we want to know the speed. So this is the 0.8 that we know. So we have the same equation for the centripetal acceleration. This implies that the velocity going to be centripetal acceleration times the radius square root of that. So over here, NG, so we're going to put the rest in the 98. meters per second squared times the 12 meters. Square root of that. So that is square root. Radiate times 12 is 1176 meter squared, second squared, square root of that. Now this is going to be 34. Only 3 meters per second. So in these two problems, or no problems, we just manipulated the equation of the center.